The past couple of days have been difficult ones for this department as we mourn the loss of Larry Kaiser due to a tragic accident on Tuesday morning. As a civilian tow truck operator, Larry was a valued member of this department and a part of the police family. He served this department with honor and distinction for 18 years with Louisville Metro. You know, often the public, and quite frankly, some of our officers, I think, take for granted the work of our civilian employees, but I will tell you, without the support that we get from our civilian employees, there's no way we would be able to do the job that we do in trying to protect this community. Larry went out on the job on Tuesday morning. He was removing an abandoned truck from I-64 in order to keep that roadway safe. It's just that kind of effort that we don't take time often to recognize, and I think we as a department and we as a community need to do a better job of doing just that. Larry gave his life serving this community, and I hope that you will join me in continuing to pray for his family and his friends. I also hope that each of us will try to show more gratitude to the public servants of this city, those folks who go out each and every day and perform tasks, both big and small, to do what they can to make Louisville a better and safer community. And now I want to turn things over to Major Jamie Schwab from our Special Investigations Division to provide a few more details about what happened on Tuesday morning. Major Schwab?
Thank you, Chief. Obviously, it's been a very difficult New Year's for LMPD. As the Chief said, I'm Major Jamie Schwab with the Special Investigations Division, which includes our Public Integrity Unit. The investigation is being handled by Public Integrity since it involved an on-duty death of a Metro government employee. Additionally, the LMPD Traffic Unit is assisting with the investigation by completing the technical reconstruction of the accident scene. So I'm going to read a brief timeline of the events that occurred on Tuesday, and then I'll take any questions you may have. On December 31st, 2019, at approximately 8:44 a.m., LMPD Vehicle Impoundment Unit 11, which was being operated by Mr. Larry Kaiser, was dispatched by MetroSafe to tow an abandoned Ford F-150 pickup at I-64 westbound, just west of Cannons Lane. The abandoned truck was initially tagged for tow on December 24th, 2019, but is a low priority since it was not causing a traffic obstruction. At 9:13, a civilian witness was traveling east on I-64 and called 911. They reported seeing an unoccupied LMPD tow truck at the location moving in reverse. At 9:16, another passerby observed the LMPD wrecker at the same location with the F-150 connected, but the rear of the abandoned truck partially sticking out in the driving lane of I-64. Finding this unusual, this Good Samaritan pulled over in front of the scene to render aid. He reported the incident via both his cell phone as well as by using the LMPD radio in the tow truck. Around the same time, another VIU wrecker arrived on the scene, followed closely by an LMPD traffic unit. These units confirmed that Mr. Kaiser was under his wrecker and non-responsive. The arriving VIU driver also reported securing Mr. Kaiser's vehicle by entering the cab and ensuring that it was no longer moving. At 9:28, Louisville Metro EMS reported that Mr. Kaiser appeared to have suffered fatal injuries at the scene. The preliminary information indicates that Mr. Kaiser had hooked his wrecker onto the abandoned vehicle and lifted it from the front. It then appears that he crawled under the F-150, possibly to manually disengage the truck's transmission and enable the rear wheels for towing. The presence of a crowbar at the scene further supports this. At some point, the tow truck and towed vehicle began to roll backwards, entrapping Mr. Kaiser under the rear axle of the wrecker. This was the position he was found when responding units arrived. The state medical examiner has confirmed that the manner of death was accidental and was consistent with mechanical asphyxia. One key piece of information that will involve identifying if any mechanical defects could have caused this accident will be conducted tomorrow. We do have a full mechanical inspection scheduled on the wrecker, and this will be done by an independent third party. So with that being said, I'm open for any questions.
Was Mr. Kaiser's tow truck in reverse when the witness came in and secured the truck?
We're going to wait for the mechanical inspection to determine that, because at this point in time, we don't know whether there was a mechanical failure with the transmission of the vehicle or what state it was in. As I mentioned, one of our drivers did get there and did secure to make sure it's not rolling any further, and those interviews are still ongoing.
Do you know how old that truck was?
I believe it was 2015 was when the truck was the model year.
Are you aware of any recalls on it?
I am not.
Have cases like this been reported by departments anywhere else in the country? Has your agency looked to see if there's anything similar to this?
That will be part of our investigation. Like, obviously, we're just a couple days in, so that will be something that we will look at further. You know, we're going to be very thorough in terms of making sure that, you know, mechanically the truck was sound, as well as looking at anything, you know, that could have been done differently, you know, in the situation.
I have a question, and I don't know if Lamont or the chief might be better to answer this, and this is about line of duty death benefits. The law was changed a couple of years ago to make sure that line of duty death benefits would be extended in some situations where they weren't before. Do you know if there's any, or is your department concerned about that this time around? And how does that work in this being a civilian employee of the LMPD? Do you know?
I don't know the answers to your questions. I know that the director of our human relations unit here in the police department has had the opportunity to meet with Mr. Kaiser's family and to discuss benefits, but I'm not aware of the specifics of those discussions. One thing that I will add, I know also the family is working with members of our peer support team this morning. They'll be meeting with a funeral home, and they're trying to put together arrangements for Larry's funeral. And at this point, we don't know anything, but as soon as those details are available, we want to share them, obviously, with our employees, but also with the public.
How many civilian tow truck drivers do you guys have?
I do not know that off the top of my head.
Okay.